Tonight was a game of runs early. Brooklyn was scorching out of the gate, and Cleveland answered back. We have reached the break, and with the eyes of the NBA focused on the Nets, they are within 2 points of the Cavaliers, down 51-49. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Nets Halftime Show with Frank Isola. I'm Nancy Newman. We are witnessing the debut of Brooklyn's Big Three. The Nets posted a perfect start, Frank, going 10 of 10 from the field. Absolutely highlight reel stuff, shot after shot, but then after that, a leveling, they let the Cavaliers find their rhythm.
Well, I really thought early on the Nets were having a lot of trouble holding onto the ball. Too many turnovers. Yep. Kyrie had 4 in the first half. James Harden had 3. That was the biggest issue with them offensively. And then also they did a pretty good job defensively with transition baskets for Cleveland because of those turnovers. But early on, the 10 for 10, that was lights out shooting by the Nets.
That was incredible to watch. Okay, we'll see how this thing plays out. Offensively, they were on fire from the jump.
Well, it seems like part of the plan here was get Kyrie Irving going off early. Yeah. You know, he took 9 shots in the first half. James Harden and Kevin Durant combined for 11 shots, and James Harden didn't even take a shot in the first quarter. I think James Harden, his game, he's got to be much more of a scorer, in my opinion, to be successful. Now, Kevin Durant, he's going to get his shots no matter, you know, where you are, who he's playing with. This is what's interesting, Nancy. That group played together the first 6-17 of the first quarter, and they played the last 4:25 together. So it was about a combined 11 minutes that they played together, and the Nets were a +7 with that group out on the court.
So Coach Nash obviously finding how to distribute the minutes.
Exactly. That's going to be the biggest thing, learning where to stagger the minutes. So he just decided, I'll play them all together at the start, and I'll play them all together at the end. You know, in a close game, all three guys will be out there, especially in the fourth quarter.
There are the numbers all told. Kevin Durant with those 11 points, 2 from James Harden, 0 of 2 from the field. 4 assists, though, from him, 6 from KD, and Kyrie, 17 points. Time for a break. Stay with us on the Halftime Show. We've got more to come as we get you set for the rest of the action in Cleveland. The Nets trail by 2.
And especially James Harden. He had a lot in the first half. And then here, everyone making that extra pass. Joe Harris, of course, has to get his 3-pointer in, keep his streak going. That's what made it 10 for 10.
Yeah, Jordan was a big-time beneficiary. But you wanted to talk about James Harden, and you wanted to talk about specifically that you felt like he was deferring in that first half.
And I think a lot of this probably has to do with the fact that Kyrie Irving just came back. They probably want to get him more involved. But look at these numbers right here on James Harden. You don't see this from him very often. Had he not made those 2 free throws at the end of the first half, it would have been the first scoreless half for James Harden since January of 2015 against the New Orleans Pelicans. So he's a scorer. He's a playmaker and a scorer. To see him go an entire quarter, now granted, he was out the last 6 minutes, but not to take any shots. To me, he needs to be more aggressive. He's too big time of a scorer not to take any shots.
And that after 2 30-point games in his debuts.
Exactly. Well, this is always going to be the challenge now,
right,
with having 3 terrific offensive players. Kyrie Irving had it going. He was 8 for 10. The 4 turnovers weren't good enough, but 8 for 10, Kyrie was terrific. But James Harden didn't look like the James Harden we had seen in the first 2 games. I think you'll see him be much more aggressive in the second half. I think Steve Nash will tell him, play your game. Get involved with Kevin Durant. Start attacking the basket. Draw fouls. That's what he's great at. He was really quiet that first half.
Eager to see those adjustments. Yep. Brooklyn is trying to win its 5th consecutive game, while Cleveland is looking to put together back-to-back victories for the first time in almost a month. Odds going into the second half are